Nodular melanoma is the second most common type of cutaneous melanoma in fair-skinned individuals, which account for 15 to 30% of all melanomas. It is believed to arise as a de novo vertical growth tumor without the initial radial growth phase. It is more common in males than females over 60 years of age. The clinical aspects consist of a firm blue to black but sometimes pink to red papular nodule, which may be ulcerated. The preferential sites are the trunk and head and neck region. From a clinical point of view, the well-known ABCD clinical criteria do not help, and the EGF rule, where E stands for elevation, F for firm consistency, and G for progressive rapid growth, is more appropriate to facilitate the diagnosis of nodular melanoma. This is an example of a dermal nevus, which, in contrast to a nodular melanoma, is not clinically firm and can easily be moved on both sides with a dermatoscope. Dermoscopy may help to diagnose nodular melanoma and to differentiate this entity from other melanocytic and non-melanocytic lesions. One of the most robust methods is based on the blue-black feature, defined as the presence of a combination of blue and black pigmented areas involving at least 10% of the lesion surface. This lesion clearly shows the dermoscopic blue and black rule associated with clots and dots, brown to black, irregularly distributed. Histology on the right side shows consumption of the epidermis and the presence of neoplastic cells, either isolated or in nests, located in the entire epidermis and in the dermis. Unlike the extensive literature on superficial spreading melanoma, a few data are available on the dermoscopic features of nodular melanoma. Some authors proposed the following dermoscopic features as characteristic of nodular melanoma, including brown to black clots and dots, irregularly distributed, structural zone blue or black, structural zone pink, large diameter vessels, predominant peripheral vessels, and ulceration. This is a pigmented nodular melanoma characterized on the left side by brown to black clots and dots, irregularly distributed, whereas on the right side we predominantly see blue structural zone indicated by the white arrow. In the central part of the lesion, ulceration and crust are visible. This hypopigmented nodular melanoma displays irregular clots, brown, round, or oval, and in the central part of the lesion, atypical vessels are clearly shown, mainly in the shape of curved and linear vessels, as indicated by the white arrows. Another nodular melanoma characterized by pink structureless areas and the blue structureless zone indicated by the black asterisk. Truly, amelanotic melanoma can be characterized exclusively by the presence of polymorphic vessels and can be difficult or impossible to differentiate it with a squamous cell carcinoma. Differential diagnosis with other melanocytic and non-melanocytic skin lesions is also possible. Here are some examples. From a clinical point of view, the lesion can be difficult to be differentiated from a melanoma. However, in these cases, the clue is represented by lines radial connected to a common base, which is prototypical of a basal cell carcinoma. To Two additional examples on the left side, the lesion is characterized by clots, white and shiny, and by branched vessels as in the lower part of the lesion. The right lesions shows almost exclusively Brugge areas, so the diagnosis is BCC on the left lesions and nodular melanoma on the right lesion. Rarely nodular melanoma should be differentiated with dermatofibroma characterized by structural zone white central. However, in nodular melanoma, additional features such as atypical vessels, as shown in this case, are present. So, in conclusion, nodular melanoma, it may have symmetry of pattern, so clinical awareness is needed. Most pigmented and hypopigmented nodular melanoma lesions have dermoscopic features that allow their diagnosis. However, be careful, any nodular lesions that cannot be confidentially diagnosed as benign must be surgically excised.